Okay, yesterday we have done the multiplication of a scalar with a vector quantity. Like mass is a scalar quantity, can be multiplied to a vector quantity like acceleration, and the product is a vector quantity, that is the force. Okay, now two vectors are multiplied. Okay, yesterday we have studied a scalar multiplied by a vector quantity. Now two vectors multiplied, and the product may be either a scalar quantity or it may be a vector quantity. If it is a scalar quantity, such a product is called as the scalar product, or it is also called as dot product. It's also called as dot product. So write scalar product or dot product. Scalar product or dot product. Write down two vectors are multiplied and the product is a scalar quantity. Two vectors are multiplied and the product is a scalar quantity called as scalar product. Write down, it is also called as dot product because it is written as A vector dot B vector. So here the multiplication sign which we are using is dot. Okay, so it is written as A vector dot B vector. Okay, now let this is A vector, B vector, making an angle theta. Okay, now we'll find out how much is A dot B equal to. Let us find out the component of B along this vector, along A vector, or you may say along X axis. Yes, you can unmute and tell me. What is the component of B along horizontal? What is the component of B along A vector, or you may say along horizontal or along X axis? What is
B cos theta.
Okay, so A dot B is equal to magnitude of the first vector multiplied by the component of the second vector along the first vector. What is the component of the second vector along A vector? B cos theta. So A dot B is equal to A into B into cos theta, where theta is the angle between the two vectors. Okay, now forget about vector addition. What was theta and everything, parallelogram law. Here we are multiplying two vectors. A dot B is equal to magnitude of A vector into component of B vector along A. And what is the component of B vector along A? It is B cos theta. So A dot B vector is equal to A into B into cos theta. Okay, so write down A dot B is equal to A into B into cos theta. Okay, now few examples. Think of any two vectors multiplied and the product is a scalar quantity. Any such quantities you have studied? Two vectors. Well, yes. Yeah, too noisy. Any two vectors multiplied and the product.
Goes into displacement.
Yes, work is. You multiply two vectors, force and displacement, both are vector quantities, and the product you get it as work. So work is the scalar product of force and displacement. Okay, if the angle between force and displacement is cos theta, then it can be written as F into S into cos theta. Okay, now see here, there is no vector sign. It is a scalar product. It will not have any direction. It has only magnitude. Okay, here you will not write any vector, no unit vector, nothing. No I cap, J cap, K cap, anything. F into S into cos theta. First example. Let us divide both sides by time. Work done upon time taken. Force dot displacement upon time taken. Work upon time, we know is equal to, okay, nobody knows, is equal to power. Rate of doing work, power. So work done per unit time is power. Force dot displacement per unit time is the velocity vector. So again, two vectors are multiplied. And the product is a scalar quantity. Power is a scalar quantity. So power is the dot product of force and velocity vectors. If the angle between force and velocity is theta, then it can be written as F into V into cos theta. Okay, so power is the dot product of force and velocity vectors. Okay, written. Now we'll study few properties of scalar product. Some properties here we'll study. First property, obeys commutative law. Obeys commutative law. Okay, now we are not talking about the vector addition. The scalar product, the dot product obeys commutative law. That is, A dot B vector is equal to B dot A vector. Okay, if the angle between A and B is theta, then A dot B vector is equal to A into B into cos theta, where B dot A vector will be equal to B into A into cos theta. AB cos theta is equal to BA cos theta. Okay, no direction is there. A into B is always equal to B into A. 3 into 2 is always equal to 2 into 3. So A dot B vector is equal to B dot A vector. Okay, because this is only having the magnitude, AB cos theta will be equal to BA cos theta. Keep writing. Now the second property is, it obeys distributive law. Obeys distributive law. That is, A dot B plus C vector will be equal to A dot B vector plus A dot C vector. Is equal to, okay, this is the distributive law of multiplication over addition, is equal to A dot B vector plus A dot C vector. So it also obeys the distributive law. Okay, obeys the commutative law, obeys the distributive law. Okay, now the third property. Write down. Dot product of two vectors acting along same direction. Acting in the same direction. Dot product of two vectors in same direction. You have to write yourself, is equal to, what is theta?
Zero.
Theta here is 0 degree. Okay, theta here is 0 degree. Why? Because the angle between two vectors which are in the same direction, the angle is 0 degree. And A dot B, we know, is equal to A into B into cos theta. So A into B into cos 0. Cos 0 is equal to
1.
Yes. Cos 0 degree. So it is equal to the product of the magnitude of the two vectors. is equal to the product of the magnitude of two vectors. Okay, and this value will be maximum. Okay, cos 0, 1 has a maximum value. Okay, now you will fill up yourself. I'll say only the statement. Dot product of two vectors acting in opposite direction. Dot product of two vectors in opposite direction. That is, let A vector is acting towards right, B vector towards left. Find out A dot B.
Minus of AB.
Yes. Why? Because here theta will be equal to 180 degree. Okay. Any two vectors acting in the opposite direction. Okay. This is A vector. This is B vector. So what will be the angle between them? 180 degree. Here the angle between them is 0 degree. Okay. So A dot B is equal to A into B into cos 180. And we know that cos 180 is equal to minus 1. So it is equal to minus AB. Next, write down. Dot product of a vector with itself. Dot product or scalar product, you can write down. Dot product of a vector with itself. That is A dot A vector. A dot A means both are equal vectors, same magnitude, same direction. This is A vector, this is also A vector, same magnitude, same direction, is equal to?
Ma'am, A square.
Yes, is equal to A square. Why? Because the angle, we know that A dot B is equal to A into B into cos theta. A into what is the angle? Cos 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1. So it is equal to square of its magnitude. Is equal to A square. Next property, dot product of two perpendicular vectors. Of two perpendicular vectors. Let this is A vector. And this is vector B. We have to find out A dot B is equal to
0.
Yes, A into B into cos 90, and we know that cos 90 is 0, so A into B is, A dot B vector is 0. Kindred? Okay, so A dot B is equal to 0. Okay, write the next property. Are you getting it? Very simple. Okay, seventh property. Dot product of unit vectors. Okay, scalar product of unit vectors. Unit vectors I cap, J cap and K cap. Let's find out I, J, K, I dot J, J dot K, K dot I. Fill it up. We have studied all the properties using these properties only. Magnitude of any unit vector is 1. I cap, J cap, K cap, all these are having magnitude 1.
I dot I is 1.
Yes. I dot I. 1 into A square. One. Okay, this is magnitude is also unity, this magnitude is. And what will be the angle between these two vectors? Both are acting along x-axis, so cos 0. So it is 1 square, that is 1. The same way, J dot J is equal to 1, K dot K is equal to 1. I dot J?
0.
Yes, I dot J? 1 into cos 90. Okay, like a dot b is equal to a into b into cos theta. So here magnitude of I dot 1 into what will be the angle between these two? One is acting along x axis, the other one along y axis. So cos 90 is 0. So all these are 0. Okay, one more property, let us discuss. The dot product in rectangular components. Let A vector is given as AX, I cap, AY, J cap, AZ, K cap. And B vector is also given in rectangular components in three dimensions, BY, J cap plus BZ, K cap. Okay, now find out when it is given in rectangular components, find A dot B vector. Do it yourself.
AX, BX plus AY, BY plus AZ, BZ.
Yes, very good. Okay, the same way. This whole thing dot BX, I cap. Now, how do you multiply AX into BX? I dot I, we know is equal to 1. So, AX into BX. 1 minute.
मैंने इसमें बोला था कि मेरे पास टेक्स्ट आ रहा
है नहीं तो अभी लिख दें टेक्स्ट भेज दो
क्योंकि ये मशीन चार्ज करने वाली
है ये तो हार्डली वेरी फ्यू है सर ओनली सप्लीमेंट्री है
उनका ये कहना है वो जिसकी ड्यूटी है वो करे आप समझो इस बात को लेके बहुत प्रॉब्लम है
हाँ ऐसे तो म्यूचुअली चल जाए तो चल जाए नहीं चल जाएगा अगर चलो ठीक है मैंने राजू सर को बोला है ठीक है नाउ टुडे राजू सर विल राइट समथिंग इन द ग्रुप अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट विल फॉलो ओके 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 ax into bx i dot i is 1 ax into by i dot j 0 I dot k 0. So what do we get? AY into BY J dot J. This will be 1. So it will be AY BY plus AZ BZ. Okay. So A dot B will be equal to no vector sign will be here. No I cap, no J cap. It is a scalar product. The product will be a scalar quantity. Okay. By mistake, don't write any vector I cap, J cap or K cap over here. Okay, so these were few properties which we have studied. Write two questions so that we can proceed for vector product. Write down. Let force vector is given as 3x, 3i cap plus 2j cap minus k cap and the displacement is 4 meters along y axis. Find the work done. This much Newton you can write down. Yes, use this only. Displacement is 4 meters along y axis. So how can the displacement vector be written? Along y axis, the unit vector along y axis is j cap. So 4 j cap meters. Now find out, we know that the work done is force dot displacement vector. force dot displacement vector. Here I cap 0. Okay, 2 into 4 is how much? 8. J dot J will be 1. Here k cap is 0. So how much is it? 2 into 4, 8. If this is given in newton, displacement is given in meters, then the work done is 8 joules. Did you get this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, write one more. Write down. If force vector is given as 2i cap minus 7j cap plus k cap, and the velocity vector is given as I cap minus j cap plus 2k cap, find power. Power we know is equal to force dot velocity vector. Hurry up. I dot I will be 1. So 2 into 1, 2. Minus 7 into minus 1, plus 7. 1 into 2, 2. So how much is it? 11 units in whichever unit it is given. If this is in newton, this is in meter per second, then you will get it in watt. Did you get this answer? No? Nobody got?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. Write one last question. Write down. If A vector is 3i cap minus m into j cap plus k cap, and B vector is 2i cap plus j cap minus k cap, find the value of m for A and B to be perpendicular. If A and B are perpendicular vectors, are perpendicular, find the value of m. Find the value of m. If A and B are perpendicular, find the value of m. Not done. Too long you are taking.
Ma'am, it goes to 5.
I'm 5.
Okay. Okay. If A and B are perpendicular, then A dot B should be equal to 0. Okay. We know that. What is the condition for perpendicular vectors? A dot B should be equal to 0. Find A dot B. 3 into 2, 6. Minus M into 1, minus M. Plus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Should be equal to 0. A dot B is AX BX plus AY BY plus AZ BZ. Okay, so 6 minus 1, 5 minus M is equal to 0. That is, M is equal to 5 for these two vectors to be perpendicular. Write one last question, then we'll proceed with vector product. Find angle between A and B vectors. Where A vector is 2i cap minus k cap, and B vector is 3i cap plus j cap minus 2k cap. Find the angle between the two vectors, A dot B, that is theta. Find out cos theta. Angle means find out cos theta over here. What can be done? We know that A dot B is equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta. Substitute A dot B. 2 into 3, 6, minus 1 into minus 2, plus 2. Okay, here J dot is 0. Magnitude of A vector, will be under root AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. That is 4 plus 1. Okay. Into magnitude of B vector. Magnitude of B vector is 9 plus 1 plus 4 into cos theta. So here you get cos theta to be 6 + 2, 8 upon under root 5 into under root 14. Leave it as such. This is the answer. So what is the angle?
Yes. Ma'am, please repeat this question. I couldn't understand.
Find the angle between A and B vectors. Where A vector is this, B vector is this. You have to find out angle theta between these two vectors. Okay, using dot product we are finding out A dot B is equal to AB cos theta. A dot B, as we do it, AX, BX plus AY, BY plus AZ, BZ. What is this magnitude of A? Magnitude of A is under root AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. Magnitude of B, under root BX square plus BY square plus BZ square. Here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we proceed to vector product. How much time is left? Okay, 2 minutes more. Write down vector product, which is also called as cross product. Vector product or cross product. Okay, here two vectors are multiplied and the product is a vector quantity. Two vectors multiplied and the product is a vector quantity. So write down two vectors are multiplied and the product is a vector quantity. It is written as A cross B vector. Written as A cross B vector. Okay, that is why it is called as the cross product. There we put the multiplication sign as dot. Here we put the multiplication sign as cross. So that is why it is also called as the cross product. Okay, we are multiplying two vectors and the product is a vector quantity. Let the same vectors, A vector, B vector, making an angle theta. Yes, here. It is having some magnitude and some direction also. Okay, in the dot product, only magnitude is here, no direction. Here, the product is having some magnitude as well as direction. Magnitude is A into B into sine theta. Okay, A into B into sine theta. Which component? Perpendicular component of B here is taken. So, magnitude of A into magnitude of B into sine theta. And it is having some direction also. Let us write the direction to be n cap. The whole magnitude is this. Only the direction of A cross B vector is represented by a unit vector. Is represented by a unit vector. Okay, which is giving only the direction of A cross B vector. Let me write it as n cap. Okay, unit vector n cap. Okay, now the direction of unit vector, this direction of A cross B vector, it is determined by right hand thumb rule, or there is one more rule, right hand screw rule. Okay, so here we'll discuss only one rule, right hand thumb rule. Okay, so the magnitude is AB sine theta, direction we have written by n cap. Now how do we get the direction of n cap? That we'll discuss tomorrow. Okay, so don't leave the meeting. Let me take the attendance.